Welcome, friends. My name is Pastor Dan Whitener. I am privileged to serve as pastor here at Lutheran Church of God's Love in Newtown, Pennsylvania. Welcome to this second week of a musical worship midweek experience. Today, we are going to focus on the theme of gratitude. Last week, we focused on hope. Today, we will focus on gratitude. All the four musical pieces will center around that theme. One of my favorite stories in the Gospels is in Luke 17, where Jesus heals 10 lepers, and only one of those lepers saw fit to turn around, to kneel down, and to worship and give thanks to Jesus for the grace and the healing that occurred for this leper. I want to share a few thoughts on the theme of gratitude today from a book called Grateful by Diana Butler Bass, and I would recommend this resource to you. Let me share a few thoughts from some of the saints concerning gratitude. This is from Karl Barth. Grace and gratitude belong together like heaven and earth. Grace evokes gratitude like the voice and echo. Gratitude follows grace like thunder, lightning. And a second from actually a former faculty member of my college, Wake Forest University, Maya Angelou. The wisest thing you can do is be present in the present gratefully. And finally today, from a Benedictine monk, David Steindl Rast. If you're grateful, you're not fearful. And if you're not fearful, you're not violent. If you're grateful, you act out of a sense of enough and not of a sense of scarcity, and you are willing to share. If you are grateful, you are enjoying the differences between people, and you are respectful to everybody, and that changes this power pyramid under which we live. I invite you, as you listen to this music this week, and as you meditate and worship in this way, that you do your own gratitude inventory and just think about all of the blessings that you receive in the course of this day. God bless you, and I yearn for the day when I will see you all face to face again.
Give Thanks with a Grateful Heart, commonly known as Give Thanks, was written in 1978 by Henry Smith. It was written after Smith had trouble finding work after graduating from college. He also suffered from a degenerative condition that eventually left him legally blind. While at his church in Williamsburg, Virginia, his pastor inspired him with a reference to how Jesus made himself poor to make others rich through him. When Smith started performing this song in church, a visiting United States military officer heard the song and took the song to Europe, from where its popularity spread.
Hi, everyone. Welcome to my back patio. Since we're talking about gratitude this week, I thought it would be appropriate to video this for you from one of the spaces I'm most grateful for in my home, which is my backyard space. The first hymn I've chosen for our hymn sing this week is Praise the Lord, O Heavens. This is set to a tune written by Haydn, and it is found originally in a hymnal psalm book that was published by the London's Foundling Hospital. It was founded in 1739 by somebody named Thomas Coram, and it was actually an orphanage. And apparently the children displayed a great propensity for singing, and they were rehearsed and worked with by local professional musicians so that they actually became an attraction in that local area. They would sing on Sunday mornings and people would come to listen and to watch. So our words are still considered anonymous. It was found in this book, as I said, and they weren't ever really able to truly track it down to the original author, but they are beautiful words. It is a beautiful hymn, and it definitely speaks to our theme of gratitude. And I also can't think of other things much better to be grateful for than singing. Singing helps us feel good, and it helps us get into a good headspace so that we can try to find the gratitude even through these trying days. I'm grateful that we have found new ways to worship. I'm grateful that I've found ways to connect with my students in an online platform so that none of us are having to be without music at all. Sure, it's not the same as us being together live and in person, but my goodness, can you imagine if we didn't have this option? So there's always something to be grateful for. I'm grateful for all of you. I'm grateful for the many blessings in my life, and I hope you enjoy this hymn. Maybe it can give you a moment to take pause and think about what you're grateful for. Thanks so much. Enjoy.
At a church songwriting event several years ago, Hannah Hobbs and Matt Crocker teamed up to spend time collaborating and seeking God for new songs. Hannah states, "Across the 3 days, we had 7 or 8 writing sessions, each with a different combination of people. On the second day, Matt and I started our session. It was the first time we had ever written together. As a songwriter, you always hope that every writing session leads to an incredible song. But unfortunately, it doesn't always happen. That day, however, I think Matt and I both knew we had come across something special. The song, Thank You, Jesus. The idea was sparked from a comment that our creative pastor, Cass Langton, made about how it would be great to have a thank you song in church. a song themed around the message of gratitude towards God. From there, we began to work on a chorus that simply said, "Thank you, Jesus. You set me free. Christ, my Savior, you rescued me." Another part of their inspiration came from Psalm 100, verse 4. "Enter into the gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him and bless his name."
My second hymn choice for our week of gratitude is our familiar hymn, "This Is My Father's World." It's been a beautiful couple of days, and right now as you're watching this, we're in the midst of what's going to be a not so beautiful day. So as I record this, I think of how lucky we are to have had some great weather, and hopefully this will lift your spirits as we sit through some cold and chilly rain today, Wednesday. "This Is My Father's World" talks about the beauty of nature. It was written by Reverend Babcock. He lived in Lockport, New York, and he would frequently take long walks. Welcome to real life in the suburbs. Along the Niagara Escarpment to enjoy the views there. And when he would go out, he would let his wife Catherine know that he was going out to see his father's world. And so he penned this poem, which was then set to music by Franklin Shepard to the tune that is called Terra Beata, which literally translates to blessed earth. We can be grateful for our blessed earth, and maybe this time of us not being able to be together is a great opportunity for our Mother Earth to recover and replenish her resources so that it'll be that much more beautiful and lush when we get to return to it fully, whatever that may look like. So we continue our gratitude. I thank you for tuning into these. I hope that they're helpful to you. I find them soul-filling. This is This is my Father's world.